Glad to be here in our Oracle Global Leader Program. And today I would like to tell you how we at Retrace use the Autonomous Database in our infrastructure to build a fast and scalable solution in the market, and why Autonomous is just the thing you should use in your infrastructure. So what are we doing at Retrace? We are doing consumer trust through supply chain transparency for fashion brands. So when you as an end consumer go through a store, you have just, I mean, I personally have no idea anymore what all those certificates actually mean. I'm completely overwhelmed. So in the end of the day, my decision to purchase a good can't be influenced anymore by any of those certificates, because ultimately, if I want to search for something which was produced sustainable and under fair conditions, I do not know which one of those actually mean this one. Some of them are maybe about specific production standards, but have nothing to do with human labor. And maybe they might even look like they avoid child labor, but actually in the end, they don't tell us anything about this. And this is exactly what we as Retrace try to solve. What we are building is we bridge this gap for fashion brands where they have no possibility actually to get the consumers back, and actually open up the supply chains towards end consumers. So when we go through a store, you can scan and identify on each of the fashion items and actually trace down the supply chain, what has happened where, which company has actually which certificates, and can make your own decision about that. Because sometimes fashion brands are so small, they don't even have certificates, or fashion brands are so big that it's very difficult to make a general decision about if this supply chain is good or not. We give you as an end consumer actually the power back. So what has happened here is a picture in Rana Plaza in Bangladesh, where a building actually collapsed and thousands of workers died. And a lot of fashion brands were producing in that building, like H&M and so on. And they didn't even know about that. So what we help is those fashion brands also to identify what's actually going on in the supply chain. Where do they produce and explore actually their supply chain? Because most fashion brands don't even know after the manufacturer where maybe the shoe is produced, what's happening there. So what we wanted to provide is a solution which is kind of a SaaS approach for fashion brands, that basically you just join our solution, you input the data there about the companies you know so far, let's say the manufacturer, for example, and we help you to identify further companies by sending out automatic queries to the partners you work with and identify other stakeholders in the system. We focus though on just collecting the relevant information. So maybe you use already an ERP or SEM solution under the hood. So we will just connect to those and get just like the very thin layer of data out, which we really need, like company, like let's say the first contact information and the geolocation. What we wanted to be as Retrace, we never wanted to be a new, let's say, authority of trust. So we wanted to kind of say, we are not a certification for fashion brands, but we actually store the data and collect just everything they have. Because a lot of companies already offer something, let's say like a sustainable fashion lines, so where they reuse materials, for example, for new product lines and shoes. And we do not want to certify them, but we rather want to store it somewhere, have a tamper-proofed, non-changeable for anyone in the future. And this is where blockchain came in, where our solution builds up on. We have easy drag and drop interfaces. So as I said, we connect to external systems to get, for example, also the product information out. Often you have a web store already where we can just connect to. It must be absolutely cost efficient. As I said, our solution is focused for bigger brands to really handle the documentation, but as well for smaller ones, just to explore their supply chains and just put all the information in there. But you know, you can't really charge them a lot. If the quantity they produce is not that much. So actually now a solution you can get started for free in any size, which we are really happy for. So what we say, we are not the reason why you cannot be transparent in the fashion industry anymore. How's our architecture built up? As I said, I want to talk a little bit about the autonomous aspect and where we use it in our infrastructure. So we supply everyone within a supply chain with an application if they want to, Or again, here on the left-hand side, we see ERP or SCM solution, which we can connect to. They can then either, let's say a typical supply chain, how does it look like? You manufacture a shoe, and the manufacturer might have a system in place, but often ERP and SCM solutions are just for one tier. So you just know the next party in the line, but not further. So often enough, what we have realized is that in the fashion industry, even pen and paper is nice to have. It's often just a phone line and a little bit of words they actually exchange. But we try then to just take the situation as such and provide, for example, an app, which is very useful in India, for example, where they run around with phones all the time, but they don't really use SaaS applications, so I have a laptop wherever they are. But in others, they have a dashboard. So for example, for brands, obviously, where they have to input a lot of information about the products or some upload some pictures, they have a dashboard for that. And on the right-hand side, you can actually see the end consumer interaction. You're still on the old slide. Can anyone else confirm that we are on an infrastructure overview? At least that's what I can see. I'm very sorry if you cannot see the new slide, but they will be shared later. Okay, great. So on the right-hand side, we have the end consumer focus, where we actually expose all the information a brand has provided and all the supplier manufacturer within the supply chain and collect that. And as I said, just the necessary one, but yet we drive statistics and analytics on it. And we say, okay, for example, is there a possibility of, for example, fair payment in the supply chain? How can we do that? And one option is, for example, that manufacturers or suppliers provide a payslip. That's very common. Or, for example, let's say a working contract or some other certificates. So there are several possibilities for them. We also integrate in webshops, WooCommerce, Shopify, so that you can just quickly see on the point of sale, actually, the impact of the product you're going to purchase. So why autonomous? Well, for us, it was the way to go. As Retrace, we started in the Oracle for Startups program. We are part of that, and we do not have a lot of DevOps expertise, at least at that time. We didn't have a lot on hand, and we just needed something to get started quickly. We need something which is self-driving, so I don't want to configure anything. I need support all the time because I do not have the DevOps expertise maybe on hand. I just need an army of being behind who can help me out whenever there's something going on. It must be easily configurable. So yet again, I just want to have one button click. I need to have the option to say, okay, if something hits the fan, if I want to just scale up because there are a lot of brands suddenly joining, I need to have this option. And it must be fair price because especially if I do not have a lot of traffic going on my autonomous services, I don't want to spend too much money. And let's face it, Oracle Autonomous Database was just the right solution for us. It's self-driving. I mean, nothing easier than a simple click on this button. I think this interface has been shown several times now. I just click Create Autonomous Database, give it a password, and off you go, and nothing to do there. But yet again, they offer all the options if you want to configure all the network and so on. On the right-hand side, easily configurable for the auto-scaling. You can even select the auto-scaling when you create a database nowadays, so you don't actually have to do anything afterwards except connecting to it and putting your data in there. The Oracle support is always available. To best extent of my knowledge, we never had any problems reaching them on any priority level and fair pricing. I mean, one database is anyways in forever free package if you do not exceed the session count or the storage. So this is amazing. And how does our infrastructure look like under the hood? Why do I want to show this? Because I want to show you where else do we use autonomous. So on the right-hand side, we have the databases, ATP for autonomous transaction processing and our autonomous data warehouse. As I said, we also use a blockchain under hood where we store all the data. And then we have a microservice architecture running in Kubernetes. And everything basically is on Oracle. And what of this infrastructure is actually autonomous? Most of it, yeah. Oracle Kubernetes Engine is given as autonomous, one-click deploy, the load balancer as well by Oracle, very easy to do that. We have actually several nowadays of those autonomous transaction processing, of course autonomous, the data warehouse as well. The blockchain, for everyone interested, please reach out to me. It's also autonomous, very easy to use. And they also provide a message broker Kafka service if you want to use it. So that's from my side. Sorry for the initial hiccup, but thanks for this opportunity.